Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Lauren Grills.
And I'm Steve Fury.
Welcome to this week's show, where we'll be talking about a couple of reminders for animal registrations and school speed zones. But first, Steve, let's chat about last week's ministerial visit.
Thanks, Lauren. Last Friday, the 1st of April, we had six ministers from the state government, that's right, six, visiting Bass Coast. And this was following the Premier's visit to Bass Coast in January, where our Mayor, Councillor Jordan Crignali, invited the delegation of ministers to Bass Coast for a visit.
Included in the six ministers who visited were Deputy Premier and Minister for Education, James Molino, Minister for Environment, Climate Change and Water, Lisa Neville, Minister for Industry and Minister for Energy and Resources, Lily D'Ambrosio, Minister for Agriculture and Minister for Regional Development, Yala Pulford, John Erin, who is Minister for Tourism and Major Events, Minister for Sport and Minister for Veterans, and last but not least, Minister for Health and Minister for Ambulance Services, Jill Hennessy.
The ministers were accompanied by councillors, council staff and community representatives on visits to areas of interest for their individual portfolios, and this included the Cape Patterson Eco Village, the Bunyurong Coastal Park, Wonthaggi Hospital and Rose Lodge Aged Care, Phillip Island Medical Hub, the Bass Valley Primary School and Wonthaggi Secondary College's McBride Campus.
This was a chance for ministers to see what is happening in Bass Coast and also what needs to happen. We have a very passionate community and it was a chance for them to highlight the issues in our shire. I was at the visit to the Wonthaggi Secondary College, Steve, and it was great to see such passion from the school community. They even had three of Wonthaggi Secondary's young leaders come in on their school holidays to meet with the minister. Deputy Premier and Minister for Education, James Molino, did visit the college's McBride campus in November and is aware of the issues that face the ageing campus. And on Friday, he also went and had a look at the proposed site for an education precinct in Wonthaggi at the end of Mackenzie Street. While there were no funding announcements and no promises made from the minister, the needs of Bass Coast in terms of education were made very clear.
They then took part in separate ministerial roundtable discussions with community representatives leading the discussions, and they covered a wide range of issues of importance in Bass Coast. So this group visit was a first for the ministers and a rare and valuable opportunity to not only advocate on behalf of the community, but also give community members a chance to engage in discussion with the ministers themselves.
With the school holidays coming to a close at the end of this week, it's important to remember that school crossings and 40 kilometre per hour school zones will come back into force on Monday the 11th of April.
So we're also reminding all motorists and pedestrians to stop, look, listen and think as students go back to school after their Easter holidays. There were a number of near misses in the final weeks of last term, with motorists driving through crossings while crossing supervisors were actually still on the crossing. So it's really important that you wait until all the pedestrians and the crossing supervisor are clear of the road before proceeding.
So make sure when you're approaching a school zone that you slow down and observe the speed limits and the school crossing rules. This ensures that everyone makes it to and from school safely.
Now, just a reminder before we go that pet registrations are due at the end of this week. Sunday the 10th of April is the due date for all pet registration renewals, so if you haven't yet, please make sure that your four-legged furry friend is registered with council.
You can pay online at basscoast.vic.gov.au/payments or via BPAY through your bank's online banking. And of course, you can always pay by dropping into any of our customer service centres and seeing our friendly staff.
So all cats and dogs over 3 months old and living in Bass Coast Shire must be registered with council, and they must also be microchipped before they're registered. So both microchipping and registration helps to ensure that if your favourite four-legged friend is lost, that they can be reunited with you as soon as possible.
Last year we issued lifetime tags, so if you have received your renewal notice this year, there won't be a new tag with it. Hopefully your puppy dog or pussycat still has their bright yellow registration tag, but if it's gone missing, please contact one of our customer service centres who can issue you with a new one.
I've done that myself, Lauren. Not my tag, I mean for me, for my dog. But yeah, really easy to replace and it's free. It's all part of the service. So yeah. And that's about all we've got time for this week. As always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we mentioned today, give us a call on 1300 BCoast. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 2211. You can also keep up to date with us on Facebook at facebook.com/Bass Coast Shire or follow us on Twitter at Bass Coast. And we'll catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au.